The centerpiece of this model is this face right in the middle. Looking from the top, it is offsetted from the external edges. Looking from the side, you can see that this face has been rotated about its central axis. Between the central face and the external flange is a complex surface that smoothly transitions between the two. Let's take a look at the cross section. There are certainly some challenges here, and we will be tackling them in this tutorial. In this model, we will only need to create one sketch. This is essentially a series of offsets from the outside edge. One thing to take note is that you are not allowed to create an offset off an existing offset. So all the offsets have to be created with respect to the outside slot sketch. Let's explain all the sketch lines we have created. We are going to use these two closed contours to create two surfaces. These will correspond to these two faces of the model. The line in the middle of these two contours would serve to create the path for the pattern on path feature. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Patch. Select these two contours. Looking at the browser, we have two new surface bodies. Next, we can use the Move Copy command to rotate the inner surface. Go to Modify, Move Copy. For Move Object, select Bodies and select the inner surface body. For Move Type, select Rotate. Click on the Select box beside Axis and select the Z axis in this case. Adjust the angle accordingly. The surface body would pivot about the Z axis. To create the transition face, go to Create, Loft. Before selecting any profiles, make sure to check the Chain Selection option. Select these two edges as the profiles. Click on the first profile. Select the tangent option and adjust the weight of the tangency by dragging the arrow. Do this until you are satisfied with the overall smoothness of the face. Repeat the same for the other profile. So the overall form of the model has been created, but these are just a patchwork of surfaces. We need to give it thickness. Before that, we need to combine these three faces into one. Go to Modify, Stitch. Select the three faces and stitch them into one. Verify this in the browser. Next, go to Create, Thicken. Select the surface and adjust the thickness. In order to create a pattern on path feature, we need to create a path. Looking at the completed model from the top, you can see that these features follow the path of a slot that is offsetted from the external edge. Looking from the side, you can see that the path is not planar at all. Rather, it follows the rise and fall of the transition face. Let's unhide the original sketch. This line represents the path when looking from the top. How do we make use of this line to create a 3D sketch? Since this is a 3D sketch, we can start a sketch on any plane. Let's just create a sketch on one of the primary planes. Go to Create, Project Include, Project to Surface. For faces, select the transition face. For curves, select the appropriate sketch lines from the original sketch. For project type, we will be doing a straight projection, so select a long vector. At this point, you will be prompted to choose a projection direction. Click on the select box and select the y-axis in this case. After confirming the feature, you can see the projected line in purple. Upon closer inspection, you can see that this projected line follows the relief of the transition face. Next, let's create a starting or seat feature for the pattern on path operation. I will be creating a sketch on an offset plane from the top. This will basically be a circle with its center point on the path. Start the extrude command. Select the profile. For the start condition, select from object and select the transition face. And adjust the distance. Next, go to create, pattern, pattern on path. For pattern type, select features and select the newly created cylindrical feature. For path, click on the select box and select the projected 3D curve. Drag out the arrow and increase the quantity of the instances as required. For compute option, select optimized. This will ensure that every instance of the pattern honors the extrude from object condition. You can see that each and every one of them extrudes from the transition face.